Good morning, guys, and or day, whatever it is when you're watching the video. Talking about compost and making soil with what you have. If you're going to do a large plot of gardening like I plan to this spring, then you need a lot of soil. And one way to get soil is to compost. So when you compost, you have to look around your yard. If you have any amount of land at all, you can get it from your yard. If you don't, you can get it from the forest. There's no law that says you can't take a rake to the woods and start raking the ground of the forest, where you will probably get a lot more nutrients than you will from my property right here. So it's not a bad idea if you really need soil. Take a couple of trash bags, rake up the leaves from the forest, and collect anything that's on the ground. Small twigs, leaves, pine needles, everything. So you can take this, and what it is, it's a really great layer for a compost bin. To put on the bottom, you should have some leaves and branches and everything. And then you put your food compost on it, scraps from the yard, chicken manure, goat manure, whatever in there. Goat manure actually can be used right away. It's a cold compost, so as soon as the goats poop, you can pick that up with some hay and you have compost immediately. I grew all of my squash and half of my garden this fall in goat manure compost that we got. So it is absolutely fantastic fertilizer. The goat manure is just fantastic. So what I've done here is I've raked up my front yard here. I'll give you a little bit of a better view of that. Just real quick, you can see the line of leaves there. That part of the yard out there is not raked. This here is, there's a pile there, got a pile there, and another pile over there. Compost bins back there behind the truck there. So right now all I'm going to do is rake up these leaves and use them. Now I have 50 gallon drums that have no lid, and what I'm going to do is use this as layers between the compost dumps from the house and the goats and the chickens. So you can put the leaves as they are right into the compost. Absolutely no problem with that. They will break down in compost. If you have a wood chipper or a shredder of any kind, even just by raking them back and forth a lot, you'll end up breaking the leaves and branches and breaking it down to smaller pieces. It will compost a lot faster, and it's more of a mulch then. And that's what I'm going to do, is I'm going to pick up these piles, put them in my barrel, wheel them over to my wood chipper, and I'm going to feed them through the wood chipper. Then they're going to dump into a big box that I have, and then when I fill that box up, I'll dump it into the 50 gallon drum barrel, and I'll keep compacting it down into the barrel to where it's real nice and tight, and put a tarp over it so no rain gets in there. That will be my cover for all of my compost. So every single time I dump a layer of compost, I'll scoop out some of the leaves and I'll put it down there. You can compost all these leaves together in one pile and keep wetting them down and turning them, and they'll break down and turn into soil. Even better if you have manure from your farm or garden or anything, or any kind of waste, any plants that you're getting rid of that are done harvesting, take the stalks from them and put them in there too. So that's what I'm going to do. And when we put it in the compost pile, as the compost pile heats up over the next few months and gets to that ideal temperature, you know, we're going to end up cooking a lot of the bad stuff out of there. So I don't know if this compost will be ready for the spring garden, but if I wanted to, I could shred this down to a fine mulch and mix in some soil that I'm going to pick up in my truck, and mix a 50-50 mix of that and put that in my raised beds, which I'm going to make out of the trees that I'm cutting down to get out of the way for the garden area. I'm going to use the tree trunks themselves after I cut all the branches off, and I'm going to cut the trunk in half, and then that will be our garden. I'm going to make raised beds that are 5 foot long, 4 foot wide, and it will be made entirely out of tree trunk. And there's a lot of trees that have to come down. Some of them are being beetle killed. Some of them are just in the way where we get some really good sun, and they don't have a shade benefit for animals or the house. And so yeah, that's it. Now I'm just gonna do this and bring it over to the shredder and shred it all up in the wood chipper, and we'll show you what that's like. There's the leaf pile. I still got one more little itty bitty one, and then we'll shred this up. I'll show you what I mean in case you're not understanding about shredding. But basically, I'm gonna put it through the mower. I've got this great big box, and I have a wood chipper, not a mower. And I'm gonna chip it, this whole pile, into this box because the output is not tall enough to go into the can. So when it goes in here and this fills up, I will then dump it into this barrel right here, and I'll compact it down. I'll bring it over to my compost pile, and every single time I get a good layer of food on there, like one on the right side's got a good layer of food, I can cover it with this so it biodegrades and heats up underneath there, and worms and other stuff want to go instead of cats and whatever else is lurking around at night out here eating out of the compost pile. I want it to biodegrade. I don't want to feed the wildlife. So, okay, well, let's get to it. Okay, here's the chipper, and so you can see the size of it. This is my hand on the chipper entrance right here. So it's pretty good. It goes up to 3 inches in diameter sticks. So mulching is going to be no problem. I'm going to go ahead and put it in a cardboard box because, as you can see, the chute is not tall enough to go into the metal can. So I'm going to store it in here. When this fills up, I'll dump it in the can. Now, something to be careful, if you're using a chipper to mulch up all your leaves, the exhaust is right there, okay? Anything that gets close to this will heat up and melt if it's plastic or anything, or get warped. So you want to be very careful. So that is why I've ripped off the lip of the cardboard on this side, so it doesn't catch fire, because it will. It gets extremely hot, so you have to be careful. This will actually shoot a pretty good distance. Alright, so let's start this thing up. I haven't started it in about 2 or 3 weeks, so let's fire up and see how she does. So, after pulling it about 2,000 times and getting fuel through it because the tank was empty and I had to prime it, she finally started. I'm not going to let you watch my workout, but I got it done. Now let's mulch. Yeah, I did shred leaves up a little bit, so we have smaller leaf debris instead of a full leaf, and that's why it will compost a little faster. And so if anybody's wondering how much did that one box add up to when pushed into the barrel, pushing down with my hand, just to push down with my hand, not stepping in it and really compacting it, it gave me half a barrel. So 25 gallons of compact soil. How to compost your way where you live. That's basically the secret I'm trying to tell you. Is everybody, you always read a blog or watch videos on how is the best way. If you're trying to decide which method is best and you're looking at different methods, which one is going to work best where you live? And there's only one true way to find out. You cannot just copy somebody else. What you need to do is you need to do all of those methods right where you live. Even your neighbor's yard could be different. So You could have rocks over there and not right here. And in fact, I do have rocks right over there, but where I'm standing here, I don't. The ground is different. So no matter where you live, choose the methods that you want to know about and do them, do all of them, side-by-side comparison. And that's what I'm doing right here behind us. The method is using cardboard to lie down on the ground in order to help compost the ground and get it ready for spring. So in the fall, even though I'm in a t-shirt right now, it's almost going to be 80 degrees today in December. I know it's crazy. But get a cardboard box, open it up, find out where the seam is, separate the seam, and when you separate the seam, you will open it up until you have it wide like this. And then you're just going to lie this on the ground, right where you're going to compost, like right here. Now, the methods that I'm talking about is all the leaves that I raked up from my yard, I've made a pile right over here. This one, I raked all the leaves off of the ground, and then in front of it, I didn't do anything. It's just naturally in its state. Leaves fell from the trees, they're lying on the ground, I didn't rake it, I didn't do anything to it. But now that I have three different patterns that I want to know which one does the best, and all this ground is exactly the same, I'm going to cover each one with cardboard. And I have a stack of cardboard from all the boxes that were moving boxes and everything else that I've separated and broken down. I'm going to cover them up. I'm going to cut some wood up, lay the wood on top of the tarp that goes on top of the cardboard boxes. And then in the spring, when I'm ready to plant, I'm going to remove it and reveal it, and we will see exactly which method worked best and what was the difference. That's how you find out what works best for you. You cannot copy anybody else's idea. Your next door neighbor has different ground. Something could be different. You never know. So do an experiment with the type of ground that you have where you want to garden, and take the time to invest for the season. It's worth it. That information that you will get will lead to the rest of the years of your life gardening there to be done the best way. And that's what you want to do. You want to garden the best way you can for where you live. And nobody doing it any other way that they are trying to teach you how to do it, professional or YouTuber or vlogger or vlogger or whatever, is going to show you the best way to do it, because they have not been where you live doing it right there on that ground where you're standing. So experiment, compare, take notes. Always take notes. Every time I plant a seed, temperature, weather conditions, type of soil that I used, type of fertilizer I used, everything, because that is a book I don't have to buy, that I can go back and have valuable knowledge of what went wrong, what went right, and why, and how, what was being used, what happened, what was the difference, when you find similarity in that. So always take notes, get a binder, a book binder, and start recording and writing down notes on everything that you do with your garden. Where'd you get the seeds? Where did they come from? How old were they? You know, what type of soil did you buy to put in there? Did you buy soil? What kind of mulch did you use? What was the temperature outside? How windy was it? Was there a certain pollen that was going on in the air? These things matter. Everything matters. You know, it reminds me of the time that I was living out in California. I was making a beer, home beer kit, and we did it exactly the same every single time, but one batch came out different, and we couldn't figure out why till it dawned on us that one of the girls came over and put a flower bouquet on the table in the kitchen where me and my friend were brewing the beer. And the fragrance odor from that bouquet was in the air. It actually got into the brew and changed the taste of the beer, even though we didn't even add it. So what pollen is in the air right now when you're going to garden? What was high? Mold? Cedar? What? Grass? We need to know these things. So that's why we take down notes. All right, now let me show you a better, closer look at the comparison piles that I'm doing. Okay, so right here, it's just the cardboard that I just laid down. You you can see that I raked from the rake all the way over to this cardboard. There's the line of leaves right there that I raked up. Now there's a blank spot of undisturbed land there, and then there's the pile of leaves that I raked from my front yard, and I laid them on heavy. Several wheelbarrows dumped right there and up thicker than the ground. A good patch of leaves and pine needles sitting there. Then behind it, nothing. We didn't do anything at all to the land. So we just didn't do anything. Now we're going to take cardboard and we're going to cover it on the same sizes of all of these three areas. 1, 2, and 3. Section 1 has cardboard and tarp on it. I was going to cover this part of the ground that has nothing, which is just raked. So section 1 is totally raked. No leaves, no compost, nothing. Section 2 is about an inch of leaves on it. And there's cardboard and tarp, and then just tarp. Section 3 is cardboard and tarp on top of just natural ground. Not altered at all. Nothing put on it, nothing raked. And half of it is just tarp, just like that. Because I ran out of cardboard, and that's why I'm doing just tarp and cardboard and tarp on half of them. So, but I ran out of tarp as well as cardboard, so I can't do it to number 1. Okay, guys, that's it. That's composting in your own backyard. You doing the research yourself and taking notes. That is the only thing that is guaranteed to work. Nothing else is going to be guaranteed to work, no matter who did it or who said to do it this way, because this is the best way. It's nonsense. The best way is once you do it and you find out for a fact what worked best on the soil that you're standing on. God bless. See you in the next video. Bye-bye. Section 1 is cardboard and tarp with ground in it. On it. No ground on it. Under it. Section 1 is just the tarp and the cardboard on it. I was going to cover it. Well, it is covered. But this isn't. That is, this isn't. And I don't know what I'm saying.